Trump just stuck it to every welfare leech in America with historic move. Every day millions of hardworking Americans do their best to provide for their families and ensure that there is a roof over their heads and food on the table. However, while these honest hard workers are doing what they can to make sure that their families do not go without, there are plenty of others sitting around waiting for a government handout. Over the last 8 years, under the previous administration, Barack Obama expanded the welfare program to unprecedented levels. Instead of rewarding those that work hard, Obama penalized us and rewarded those who only milk the system. Now, President Trump is in office, and he is not messing around anymore, and he is ready to tackle the corrupt welfare system in a way we have not seen before. Barack Obama did his best during his presidency to destroy America by creating a welfare state dependent on the government. Obama and his socialist buddies know that the way to bring America to its knees is to foster a welfare mentality within our society. If an entire generation can be brainwashed into believing that the government is responsible for taking care of them, they will readily give up more of their rights for false security. Now, because of that mentality, there are millions of families living off welfare instead of looking for work, and President Trump has had enough of that, made a big change to the welfare program that has liberals screaming foul. When the welfare program started, its intentions were to help families who fall on hard times get back on their feet. Sadly, though, that has changed, and numerous individuals and families are on welfare despite the fact they are capable of working to take care of themselves. These welfare families apply for food stamps, housing aid, cash assistance, and medical insurance, which is all paid by U.S. taxpayers who are often themselves strapped for cash. In recent reports, many of these welfare recipients have come forward and claimed that it is more financially lucrative for them to be on welfare than to work. The current welfare system provides such a high level of benefits that it acts as a disincentive for work. Welfare currently pays more than a minimum wage job in 35 states, even after accounting for the earned income tax credit, which offers extra subsidies to low-income workers who take work. In 13 states, welfare pays more than $15 per hour. So, with all that in mind, President Trump has asked Congress to tackle welfare reform, and that is not all. Earlier last year, Trump brought back the Bill Clinton-era initiative that required able-bodied individuals to work in exchange for food stamps. And now more states are getting on board with welfare reform. Alabama has reported that they saw a significant drop in new welfare cases, an 85% drop, and other states have reported similar findings. Here is more from Louder with Crowder. Similar changes were implemented in select counties in Georgia, and by the end of the first 3 months, the number of adults receiving benefits in three participating counties dropped 58%, according to the Georgia Public Policy Foundation. In October 2014, LePage announced that able-bodied adults would have to find work, spend 20 hours per week in a work program, or perform community service for 6 hours a week. Food stamp participation declined 14.5% from 235,771 in January 2014 to 201,557 in January 2015, according to the state. 20 hours per week in a work program is light work. 6 hours of community service per week is less than an hour a day. Hardly taxing. Incidentally, taxes are the revenue source of these handouts. Asking people to work for money, which was taken from people who work for money, seems the fairest route to go. If we're going to continue stealing from people who work to give to others who prefer to perfect their yoga corpse pose. Namaste here, thanks. Yes, we're talking about able-bodied adults. Back off with your "but they're victims" awareness ribbon campaign. Most of these people are victims of rampant laziness. Or severe cases of I'd rather notitis. Kansas saw a 75% decline after implementing work requirements in 2013. In addition, nearly 60% of former beneficiaries found employment within 12 months, and their incomes rose by an average of 127% per year, according to the Foundation for Government Accountability. There is no reason that anyone in this country should be living on welfare when they can work. The welfare program was constructed to act as a cushion for families who fall on hard times and need a little help to get back on their feet. In no way was welfare intended to be a career choice, and when you take it away, people will do what they have to make sure they eat. After all, there is no shame in a hard work and doing your best to ensure your family is taken care of properly.